So previously we have talked about the importance of drawing or using or interpreting wind rows. This is the wind rows diagram. Starting with this second class, in this we are going to get the glimpse of what type 2 sort of wind rows diagram will depict or what is its own importance. Type 2 wind rows diagram. So, briefing about the previous class or making about the importance of wind rows, that is, it is to get the orientation of runway in a best and most feasible manner such that we can utilize the importance of or the parameters of wind in as much feasible way as we can. So the parameters of wind which actually affects or which actually going to be used by us are actually three. The first one parameter is the duration of the wind, which we have taken up in the previous class, duration of wind. Second one is the direction of the wind. And the third parameter, which was actually not there in type 1 windrows, is intensity of wind. Intensity of wind is of prime importance as it is going to affect the lateral stability. Of the aircraft which is going to fly over the runway cross section. So if I am going to draw the plan view of that runway, this is the front view of the runway. And over this, this is suppose the center line of the runway. And the aircraft is going to land over this runway in this fashion. And if I am going to denote this is like the velocity or the direction of the wind, which is making an angle of theta with the longitudinal axis of the runway, theta. So this cross wind component v sin theta is going to provide the lateral effort, to the aircraft. This aircraft is going to experience a lateral force which can make it moves sideways. So this must be within permissible limit, which actually is depending upon the inclination or the direction of the wind with respect to the longitudinal direction of the runway. Secondly, the amount of speed or the magnitude of speed with wind is blowing over the aircraft. So that is why this third parameter, intensity of wind, is important, as its cross component is going to affect the lateral stability of the aircraft. It is going to affect. It will affect the lateral. It will affect the lateral stability of aircraft. Third parameter, intensity of wind, how it is going to affect and why it is of importance in taking care of the type 2 sort of wind diagram is being clear to you, that this is going to affect the stability part in terms of lateral movement of the aircraft. So this is all sort of this. So some permissible limits are being given for this cross wind components. So the limits being imposed by the various agencies are limits on cross wind component. Categorizing the type of aircraft as it can be a small aircraft, depicting in terms of volume or the amount of passengers or carriageway or cargo it is carrying. So it can be a small aircraft, or it can be a medium aircraft, it can be a mix. This is mixed sort of aircraft. Small, mixed, and big aircrafts. So for small aircraft, this value is given as 15 kmph. And the authority going to impose these values are the two, ICAO, International Civil Aviation Organization, and FAA, Federal Aviation Agencies, have detected or meet the bar over this value of cross wind component as 15 kmph for small aircraft, as 25 kmph for mixed aircraft of category mixed, and 35 kmph for the aircraft of category big. The type of aircraft of the category is being decided on the basis of volume they are going to cutter. So the cross wind component importance, or the third independent parameter which is going to be included in type 2 wind rose diagram, is being clear to you. Now how we are going to draw this wind rose diagram, what parameters we are going to, or how we can going to interpret from that diagram, I am making that clear in this phase. So firstly drawing the wind rose type 2, three parameters are there. So let me draw the first one, the direction north, direction south, this is east, this is west. Secondly, drawing the circles. Here too, the different parameters are going to depict the different parameters of winds used. So, making some more lines, some more radial lines, in other some directions, it can be like this, it can be like this. So, naming this direction, it can be south of east, it can be north of east, it can be south of west, it is north of west. So here three things are there which are going to represent these three parameters. Three parameters are being depicted by three different terms. So I am writing here the number, duration. I am giving number 1 to duration, I am giving number 2 to direction, and I am giving number 3 to intensity. So here the duration of the wind, the duration of wind is being depicted by these sectors. Is being depicted by these sectors, like this step sector. These sectors are going to represent you what? These sectors are going to represent you the duration. How much percentage of time the winds were blowing in that particular direction zone with certain intensity. So the one, type 1, or I must say the parameter 1, are going to be depicted by these sectors, different sectors. One sector is this, other is this, other is this, other is this, 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 that and this. These different sort of sectors are going to represent to you what? The duration. Second is the direction, the radial lines. The radial lines are going to depict you what? Radial lines are going to depict you the direction of wind. And third thing is what? Intensity. The circles are going to represent to you what? The circles are going to represent you. The circles are going to represent you. Circles are going to represent you what? The intensity of wind. So if I am making it clear with a little bit, like this is some 6.4 kmph, means the radius. The radius of this circle is 6.4. Similarly, the radius of like this circle is 25 kmph. Similarly, the radius of this circle is say something around 40 kmph. So there can be a lot of concentric circles. So I think the three parameters which are going to be depicted in this graphical way, wind rose diagram, are duration given by point number 1, means the sectors, different sectors. Direction of wind means point number 2, means the radial lines. Third one, intensity by the circles. So all the three parameters are being put out here. Now how we are going to get the best orientation of runway? In the previous type 1 wind rose, we have got that longest spoke is going to give you the best orientation direction of the runway. How here we can be in a condition to make the orientation of runway got selected. So for that case, a term, or I must say two terms are going to be there which you need to actually be aware about. So two different terms. What terms are there? The first one is wind coverage. First one is wind coverage, and second term is calm period. Starting with this type 2, that cross wind component is being clear to you that this is going to affect the safe landing and takeoff operations of the aircraft. So the wind coverage is more or less related to this factor affecting the stability of aircraft. So what we actually do, we actually make three parallel lines. Step kya hai, what the step is actually, that step one while making this diagram represented is to draw three parallel lines. Draw three parallel lines. Why to draw and how this would be looking like? So this is line 1, this is line 2, this is line 3. The distance between these two lines is same. The distance between these two lines is same, which is equal to the crosswind component. The distance between these two lines is going to represent you what? The crosswind component. That means what? You are not interested to take any such direction which is going to have the crosswind component exceeding the limits. So if I am taking the case of mixed aircrafts, if I am going to take the case of mixed aircraft, for that is the limit over that crosswind component 25 kmph. So means this distance, this gap will be what? This gap will be, in this scenario, this gap will be equals to 25 kmph. So with these three lines parallel drawn over the tracing paper, making this on a tracing paper, we are going to put over here. Say, if this is that direct center line, this center line is like this, and second line, or which is going to have that gap of crosswind component of 25 kmph, is this, and third line which is going to have that gap of crosswind component of 25 kmph is this. Means you are not interested in direction or winds which are going to have this value, this crosswind component exceeding 25 kmph or 15 or 35 depending on the type of aircraft. So wind coverage is what? It is the amount of time. This sector is representing what? Duration, means percentage of time. If I am going to number this A, then A, or you can take it like 5%, or you can say, for example, you can take it like this value. This is what, say 3%. So this 3% is depicting what? 3% is, this is can be defined as, for 3% of the time, the wind is going to blow between the direction of west and southwest with intensities greater than 6.4 kmph and less than 25 kmph. 3% will depict what? For 3% of time in a year, wind are going to blow in between the direction of west and southwest, having intensities more than 6.4 kmph and less than 25 kmph. So with these percentages, you draw this, you mark all these sectors, like 3%, here it is like 6%, here it is like 2%, here it is like 1%. So with these different sectors and drawing this tracing paper, this value. And now wind coverage will be depicted by what? Wind coverage is the summation of all the percentages which are coming in between these two lines. Like making, summing up this 6 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1 plus whatever different percentages are coming within this wind rose diagram. All the summation of percentages is going to represent you the wind coverage. So wind coverage is what? Wind coverage is the percentage of time during which the wind speed is less than crosswind component. It is what wind coverage? It is percentage of time during which wind speed is less than crosswind component. Which can take values of 15, 25 or 35 kmph. So I think this wind coverage is clear to you. I have made all the direction or all the data which is out of these two lines or which is having that crosswind component more than the permitted by the agencies, unko maine bahar kar diya, and I have taken out the percentages of time within between these two bars. So in whichever direction this wind coverage is maximum, I am going to rotate this tracing paper. And in whichever direction the summation of these percentages, or I must say the wind coverage is maximum, that is going to give you the orientation of runway. So I think this wind coverage is of very important in deciding the orientation of runway, because whichever position of tracing paper you are going to get this highest value is actually providing you the best orientation of runway. So in these complete diagram, these two terms were there. First one was wind coverage and second was calm period. Calm period is defined as for a certain degree of velocity, and which I have marked here 6.4 kmph. Jitne bhi percentage of time aapko yahan pe ye mark rahe hain, these sectors, summation of percentages of all these sectors will give you the calm period, because calm period is defined as the percentage of time during which the wind intensity is less than 6.4 kmph. This is what? This is percentage of time during which wind speed is less than, or I must say the intensity of wind is less than 6.4 kmph. For wind coverage, this value was cross wind component. It can be 15 kmph, it can be 25 kmph, or it can be 35 kmph. But for calm period, the value for speed is taken as 6.4 kmph. So the two terminologies which are actually being interpreted by this wind row diagram of type 2 are wind coverage and calm period. Or here I must say that wind row diagram say best orientation. Best orientation is given in a direction of maximum wind coverage. Maximum wind coverage. So what is wind coverage, clear to you? And whichever direction or whichever position of the tracing paper is going to give you this maximum value is going to represent the direction of or the orientation of your runway. So how we can be in a condition to get the best orientation of runway using this type 2 diagram is being clear to you through that graphical representation. And within that, two different terms were there. First one is wind coverage, second one is the calm period. So this orientation of runway is very important, because if the factors being available on site which are actually beneficial for us, we are not going to utilize them, then we will be paying extra effort, or we will be making the designs, or we will be making the whatever material going to be there as uneconomic. So we actually need not to go for that. Whatever parameters we can utilize in a way, we have to make that clear over there. So this is all about this topic, second of wind Rose diagram, which is actually roamed about this orientation part. How we can orient our runway and how we can get the condition which actually be